Yo, yo, yo. What's welcome to on? Another edition of the MoCity Podcast, hosted by yours truly, Chuck, live in MoCity Studios. Now, you know what it is. This is the place where I try to politic with anybody coming through the Mo, anybody from the Mo, know what I'm saying? Anybody passing through the Mo, or anybody out here just getting something cracking. And today, man, I got a good homie in here, man. We met recently, you know what I'm saying? We was both grinding together, ended up on a set together of MoCity The Movie, you know what I'm saying? And we both got cast as brothers, you know what I'm saying? And so man, y'all see the flyer up there, and I know y'all been seeing it online. Yeah, man, this is my bro. Look, and I can say that for real. This is my brother right here, you know what I'm saying? And so, man, Chris Tyler is his name, man. If you in the industry, you might know him as Ty Jones, you know what I'm saying? And so we're gonna politic for a minute. Welcome to the Mo, bro. Appreciate you pulling up. You know what I'm saying? Hey, you back out here. You was back out here shooting. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. All in my hood. We shot in Quail Valley, bro. We shot we shot everywhere, bro. We was all in Buffalo Run Park, man. We shot at the Holiday Inn. Yeah. We shot Whisper St. James, you know what I'm saying? Shout out to everybody who helped pull that together, man. So that's how I met this young man, right? That's how I met this young man, Ty Jones, on the set. And then what I realized, not only was he playing a brother, but he was also working. Like, he was holding cameras. He was behind the scenes helping with production. Right. And so that's why, we in media production here. It was like, okay, I need to politic with him. Mm-hmm. So let's start there. Right. Let's start there, because I know that that's one of the ways you eating, right? You know, I'm all for niggas getting money. And so the photo, the photography, and the videography, which came first, that or the acting?
Definitely taking pictures.
Photography.
I always consider myself, like a natural born photographer. I was always saying that, I used to work at restaurants, and people would always ask me to come and, can you take my picture? And I'm like, hey, let me do it.
Okay, got you.
I'm going to get you right. I'm going to make sure you're good. I got you.
Yeah.
one day my brother just gave me a camera, and it was a really good Canon camera. It was T4i, to people that know about the Canons.
And T4i.
And man, he just blessed me with it. He gave me a gimbal,
So what year was this? Let me date this camera. Was this like a touch and shoot with the screen, or was it lens?
It's definitely a touch screen camera. Okay. You can pull it out, handheld camcorder. You can do whatever you want with it.
Oh, he
real
put
nice.
You in the game.
Yeah, he set me up good, man.
He put you in the game.
That was my first camera I ever had.
How old was you when he gave that to you?
I was probably like 2021.
Okay. Yeah, just finding yourself, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, just stepping out. I was living in Boston at the time. That's
okay.
Where, yeah.
Okay. Oh, so you spent some time out there on the East Coast.
On the East Coast.
How long was you out there?
I've been out in Boston for like 2 years.
Oh, because you told me, military, bro. I think you brought up that. Mm-hmm. And so your people serve?
No. I said I'm something like a military, because they move around
a lot.
They travel.
Definitely.
I stayed in A-Leaf. My people lived in A-Leaf, and then it was
shout out to the SWAT.
Shout out to the West. We want you. It was like, we want you to, go to school in Katy. So we went to school in Katy.
Okay.
And I went to Morton Ranch High School. Shout out to everybody at Morton Ranch.
Morton Ranch.
But
Morton Ranch.
Yeah, that's where I went to school at. And but I always went back and forth. I always gotcha. Had like my friend that I went to church with, my boy Jonathan.
Shout out to partners who go to church. Yeah. I got partners to this day who I still go to the same church I went to as a kid. Mm-hmm. But I got partners who we still tight to this day who we went there as a kid. So that's what's
and,
up.
And, I just, I forgot where I was going with it.
But... you were just talking about how you was moving back and forth.
Yeah, back and forth, man. Like, because his mama was like my other mama. And so,
Shout out to Sandra Simpkins, man. Shout out to Pamela McAllister, man. Shout out to RIP to Miss Gwen. Yo,
got another mama at that.
Come on, I'm trying to tell you, it's real.
Shout out to those mamas, because they make a difference in people's lives. You know, like they be doing things that other mamas don't be knowing. So. I used to always go back.
If you were looking out for you, you can come over here.
I go over there, stay the night, whatever. They was family. They still family.
For sure. Yeah. For sure. Definitely. Okay, and so that's how you kind of got moving around. And so I'm assuming, because I know I'm gonna jump back to MoCity The Movie because of Andrea. Mm-hmm. Andrea was the writer. You know what I'm saying? She the writer director.
Right.
And that's your niece. That's fam.
That's my niece. Yeah.
And so is that how the connection got you to MoCity as well to do the movie? Was it strictly through her, or was it just like a different kind of way?
So let me tell you how it happened. It was coming to do the premiere in Houston for Bad Boxer.
Okay.
And
what that when was that? That wasn't last year. Was it
last year? No, it wasn't last year. It was early in the year, kind of like February.
The Bad Boxer joint. Yeah, something like that.
Okay.
Okay, so they was out here doing a premiere.
And she came to my house. Her and Mo came to my house. And I was like, you know, come through. You know, you family. I'm gonna cook for you. I cook all the time.
Okay.
So I made them a nice little sriracha salmon with rice and zucchini.
Okay, you cook.
I cook. Yeah, I threw it down for them. So they came through and it was like, man, you know, we really want you to come to this casting event, you know, but you know, we want you to take pictures, you know. So Originally I wasn't.
They want you to come to the premiere event or a casting event?
The casting event.
Okay.
For MoCity.
Okay. So, but they told you that at the time.
In advance. Yeah. They told me in advance, like, we really want you to come out here.
Okay.
And I was like, you know, yeah, I want to go. Cause I hit her up prior. I was like, you know, I want to either write a movie, direct a movie, or just be involved in a movie, you know? And
yeah, cause at this time you already been gotten much better with the camera, you know what I'm saying?
A lot better
That's definitely the lane you in.
So
she pushing you to come take pictures.
She pushed me to come take pictures, and I was like, all right, bet, I'm gonna come do that for you. And then I get there, and I'm watching people do interviews and stuff. I'm sitting there and waiting to take pictures, and she's like,
Holiday Inn joint.
At the Holiday Inn.
Shout out to the Holiday Inn. And shout out to Go DJ C Money, made that happen.
Right. And and I was like, she told me, she's like, Chris, how old are you? I said, I'm 28. And she was like, you might be in this movie. We might need you to be in this movie. And I was like, sure, all right,
that's
I'm ready.
That's what I'm trying to tell people. Like I had a bunch of people ask me how to get in, man, pull up.
Just come through, man. And even Mo said,
now, but yeah, pull up.
Mo was like, man, you know, there'd be some roles where that need to get filled in. And if you're not there to do your role or your part or whatever, whoever's there is going to get that part. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. And shit, that happened in the MoCity movie. It was some parts where they needed a certain person to say something and they weren't there. So I filled in. So y'all going to see me saying more than just one line on MoCity The Movie. Y'all tap in July 9th.
Man, and so it's crazy because, like, at least talk about that for a second, because that was my first, time being in a film like that. Right?
Yeah, that was my first time.
Where I can say a film, period. I mean, I've done, like, you know what I'm saying, music videos and theater, whatnot, but a motion picture, right?
Yeah, nah.
And so it was interesting because I would assume that these projects had big budgets. I'd be on TV, you see trailers, you see all this stuff, right?
Right.
And so this was like, bro, pull up, come as you are. This is what we like you to say. Here's the script. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Get down and lay down kind of situation, right? And I'm like, okay. And so that was just, I was thankful for the experience.
Right.
Because it was just a new experience. I hadn't went through that. Then it was in the hood.
Yeah.
And so that's how it came to me, put you on game. So I've been knowing Said C Money. I've been knowing Said, you know, since he was in elementary school. You know what I'm saying? I used to rock with his brother.
Yeah.
His older brother. And when he was promoting the movie, I was like, bro, how you promoting a movie about MoCity? And this is my first time hearing about it.
Yeah, yeah.
But my first time hearing about it, I'm seeing logo, I'm seeing branding, I'm seeing cast of characters already. Mm-hmm. I'm seeing people I know. Shout out to Leroy III. Shout out to just people who own this flyer. I'm like, man, hold on, wait, bro. What's going on? And so I was like, bro, let me jump down. So he introduced me to Mo. He brought Mo and Andrea up here.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? And he brought them up here. We had a chance to politic. And I was like, oh, so it's open casting and it's not a story about MoCity. It's just a story in MoCity.
In MoCity, yeah.
Okay, Now I can, because I wanted to see what kind of story is being told. If this is a story about MoCity.
From your sound, you want to know what's really going on. At least
it's happening, or who put this on, right? Mm-hmm. And so somebody from Vegas going to come do, but now that I know what it is, it's really just a story set in MoCity and said really kind of was the catalyst in pushing Mo to do it.
Yeah,
you know, and said from the Mo. So he wanted a MoCity movie, and so he got one, and we all end up in it.
That's exactly how it
goes. That's kind of how it happened. But for me, it was just a brand new experience, bro. And so, matter of fact, this is a good time for me to drop the trailer right now. Y'all watch this. Bang.
Missouri City, Texas, better known as the Mo, where everything is fast, yet it seems so slow. Indulge in the tale of the brothers Mo. Different mothers, one father. His name is Pop Smoke. A gangster and a pimp and a player in these streets, trying to bring his sons together before he's deceased. The firstborn was Eli, a successful actor in movies. His mom was a crackhead and she ain't know what to do with him. Sean is a media personality who creates content, banker for the family, and not with all the nonsense. Tristan is a realtor. If you want it, he can get it. His mom was a hood rat, but moved into politics. Charles Moe is a businessman who's losing all his business to strip cloud models. He's addicted to the strippers. Drew be keeping it real, but he usually stays silent. He killed a man over a domino game because he wouldn't stay quiet. Chris is good with his hands. He's a DJ and a barber. It's sad, because he don't even know who is his mama. Edna was a runaway. We know he kind of slow. He was adopted, raised by Pop Smoke. It's the Mo brothers, no sisters, no others. Pop Smoke was a rolling stone. All different mothers. A fictional tale, but Mo City gets the glory. Brotherly love is the moral of the story.
And so if y'all saw that, man, then y'all know that it's gonna be ratchet funny, bro. It's gonna be ratchet funny, man. Shout out to, I should have had a whole list of people, but y'all see him up here, man. Shout out to Mo McCoy. Shout out to Cat TV playing Pops Mo, man. Shout out to Boo Capone, OG Boo Capone, who was there, and that's what we talked about. Like, people couldn't come, man. So we had a situation where we finished the shoot back in November, 2022. And then boys was editing, and somehow between the shoot, the finished shooting and the editing, they lost like over 2/3 of the footage.
Dang.
That was heartbreaking.
That was painful, man.
That was heartbreaking, bro. I almost dropped out at that point.
You did?
I almost did. Sid was still in it. I could tell that they still needed me. You know what I'm saying? They made a bunch of other character changes. It was still in the mold. I knew at a minimum they still finna push it and release it.
Right.
So don't drop out because of a setback. You know what I'm saying? Just kind of remix and keep it moving, you know what I'm saying? And so shout out to, I understand why people did. Like I said, Boo Capone couldn't get back in town at the time of the shoot. LA. Yeah, he just fly couldn't, just couldn't do LA, that. Bro. Leroy III had a bunch of stuff going on. He, man, I can't redo it. And so I get it, especially when niggas ain't getting paid, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
And so I totally understood that. But that in itself is why it's a ratchet comedy, I'm calling it, because you see the change of characters. You're going to notice some of the things you just said, how you said somebody else lying, because people wasn't there, you know.
It wasn't
what I'm
there. You so, had to step up and fill in.
Yeah. And so, but I'm dope. I'm thankful for the experience.
Oh yeah, man.
Oh yeah, that's what I was doing. Go DJ C Money, man. Got Los, got Jeremy, got James, Chris,
Pink the Celebrity, and everything.
Brooke Ashley, shout out to you, man. Shout out to Fox 38. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
It's going down, and so I need to update. Yeah. I think I got everybody. Sumaki Lee, what's up to you? Shout out to Tamara. Tamara, that was your chick in the movie.
Yeah, that's my girl in the movie,
If y'all saw the trailer, man, when y'all watch it, she got a funny scene. I like that. That scene was funny.
Mm-hmm.
So anyway, man, MoCity the Movie, man, coming this summer. July 9th. July you know 9th. What I'm saying? Tickets available now, man. Go to Eventbrite, search
MoCity
The Movie, or you can go to MoCity.com/MoCityMovie. And I got the Eventbrite button right there. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, you can watch the trailer again. It's right there. You can see the poster. You can get tickets.
Pull up, man. Come take a picture with your boy, man. Man, pull
for
up.
Real, it's going down, man. Shout out to the whole cast. Shout out to Fireproof Film. Shout out to 26/7 Films.
Right.
The Money Team.
Shout out to Money Team. Shout out Floyd, man. I see you, boy.
MoCity The Movie. So anyway, and back that the reason he here is because of that movie.
Right. Real talk.
He in MoCity because of the movie we met on the set. And so that's how that went. And let me just drop this plug, man. Soundtrack dropping with it. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. I got some heat for the soundtrack, bro.
I'm excited, man.
I got some heat for soundtrack, bro. Like shout out to everybody, man, who been sending songs, man. Shout out to Waterboy. Shout out to Smurfzilla, you know what I'm saying? Shout out to man, we got music on there. Man, shout out to man, I'm drawing a blank right now, but man, we got so many songs, man. Brooke actually got songs on there, Whisper St. James on there. Like gave me music, you know what I'm saying?
I was telling my boy,
38 got a song on there, like yo, it's dope, bro. So I'm anxious to drop that. That's gonna be available on all streaming platforms on July 9th, as the movie drop. So that's how I'm gonna do it. And matter of fact, small plug for all the artists I was just naming. Contacting y'all soon. I was choking up here. Contacting y'all soon via email, so y'all look out for that. Man, but back to my bro Ty Jones in here, man. Chris Tyler, you know what I'm saying? Y'all tune into the MoCity podcast. Y'all know what it is. We in here politicking, man. And so look, we share a similar experience, bro. We talking about children. When my children was young, you know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. My daughter had to be, she was in ninth grade, right? She played in the band.
Yeah.
She played the trumpet.
It's live.
And so, but dig this. I pick her up from school. We go home. I'm lying. We don't go home. I got my wife in the car. We go to eat. Chinese buffet.
Yeah.
45 South. Because at the time, I'm like living near Hobby, right? We were talking about getting vandalized. And we came out the restaurant, bro. I noticed my door was cracked. I said, man, something ain't right.
Mm.
Man, I opened up the door, bro. My radio been snatched out. My laptop was gone.
Yeah.
It was my laptop bag was gone. My camera was gone. My daughter's school laptop was gone. Her band instrument was gone. Bro, when you talk about being crushed.
Pain. Real pain.
I'm talking about real pain, bro.
Real pain.
Like, bro. Like, and so if you can, talk about the setback and the comeback. Right. Because you shared with me that when you, the camera you got stolen, was that the one that bro gave you?
Yeah, it was the one my brother gave me. It was the one my brother gave me. It was my only camera, it was my baby, man. It was my baby, man. And it really broke me, man. I was walking to my car, and like you said, like I'm the type of person that notice everything. Like if we were to get up and leave and come back and this water bottle was over here, I'm gonna notice that.
Man,
you know what I'm saying? Like who been up in here? You know what I'm saying? Yeah. So I went up in my car and just like that, man, all my stuff was gone and my gimbal, my camera. I was hurt, man, and it made me want to quit. It made me want to stop.
It seemed probably through a series of emotions. You know what I'm saying? First, you're angry, then you frustrated.
I was getting on my partners because they was outside. I'm like, man, nigga, why y'all ain't, man? Y'all supposed to be watching my back, man. Why y'all need to find who did this?
Y'all did it. You know what I'm saying? Like,
yeah, man.
Oh man,
I was mad, but you know, shout out to my baby Wendy. I love you. You know, she got me a new camera. She hooked me up with pretty much the same camera.
Okay, that's what's up.
Yeah, and you know, I just recently got a new camera lens that's gonna put me in the cinematic game.
Wendy, and that's the children's mom.
Yeah, that's okay. My girl's mama. My kid's mama. Excuse me. We gonna get married soon.
Okay.
I don't want to just say that's my baby mama because that, you know, like,
I said children's mom.
That's my
children's mom on purpose. Okay. And then you said that. So I ain't even got to pressure the question because I could see how your glow changed as soon as you brought her name up.
Yeah. Man,
you really care about her.
That's my girl.
This is, that's what's up. Y'all got two new ones. Man, make it official and make sure we get an invite. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, MoCity ENT is invited,
make
man.
Make it official, man. Make sure we get an invite and just watch your life change, bro.
Yeah.
Like, Trill Spill, watch your life change, bro. I'm a believer in black love. I'm a believer in, and I'm not sure what ethnicity she is.
Oh, she's black.
Okay, yeah. But I'm just saying, I'm a believer in that. You know what I'm saying? And I believe that if you commit to it and you communicate, it'll work. You know what I'm saying? And that's just the divine structure according to the God I believe in.
Right.
And so, man, go for it.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? And watch your life change with it.
It's already changing, man. These two kids I got, man, they just all over the place.
So you said they 1 and 2.
1 and 2.
Well, almost 1 and 2.
Yeah.
Y'all plan on having more?
Not at the moment. I want to slow down. I'm slowing down. I'm enjoying, like, my son just started walking. You know, so I'm like, you know, I'm taking my time right now, you know.
So you got
I'm enjoying fatherhood, you know.
Look, I got a 3-year-old grandson. How about that?
Yeah.
How about that? You know what I'm saying? And so I
at least you get to give him back. You get
to give him back. Man, look, and I give him back. He either go back home either super, super tired or sugared up.
Yeah.
It's 1 and 2, you know what I'm saying? And so now my grown, shout out to my youngest. Like I said, she in college. Then I got a 2 older ones, you know what I'm saying? And it's just me and wifey at the crib. Man, right now she girls tripping Nolans, you know what I'm saying? So I'm up here on the grind,
right.
You know what I'm saying?
Right up
doing
here
what I do. Doing what I do. So let's talk about the family, man, because you hustle. Right. So you hustle with the photos, you're shooting videos, but you also stay at home dad. You know
right.
what I'm saying?
I'm a stay at home dad right now.
Stay at home dad.
Stay at home dad.
Man, because look, it's necessary. I've been in that role.
Right.
I was in that role for a moment. And then I was in that role a couple of times because I was working remotely like some years ago before it was a thing. And so I was finessing work and stay at home dad because my children was little and daycare was just high as hell. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. I'm not a daycare person, man. I want to take care of my kids, man. I want to, you know, feed them myself. You know, I want to make sure that they healthy, that they, you know, well taken care of. And that's really all I want. And then, you know, for my girl, I mean, like, what else could you ask for from your spouse? You know, like, your man is here, you know, even though I don't, you know, I'm not working right now because I had an injury. I hurt my back. My spine is like real messed
ouchie,
up
ouchie,
right
ouchie.
Now. So it took me out the game for a little bit and I'm trying to bounce back. So that's
spinal
that's,
injury.
Yeah, that's where I'm at right now with it. But, you know,
man, but look,
shout
look
out to my baby because she held it down with me all the time, man. She a real one.
She a real one. Shout out to you, Wendy.
Wendy,
you know
yeah.
Salute to the real ones.
Yeah.
Straight up. Who holding down the crib and, you know. And
yeah, she holding it down, man, and still supporting me. And, you know, she sent me off to go be in this movie. And she's like, you know, took the kids. I had the kids with me on set.
Yeah, they was there. Shout out to, man, I remember that.
Yeah.
I remember that. And so yeah. Yeah, that shout out to the real ones, bro.
Yeah.
Shout out to the real ones. So I know you also you are an artist.
Yeah, right? I do a lot of art. Not Picasso, but you know.
And so artist in that fashion, like you paint, you draw, you rap, nah, you sing.
I just I can rap, I can sing.
You can rap and sing. Okay.
I can rap and sing. You just said cooking, I'll be cooking at home every day.
Because all this art to me, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, cooking, yeah, it is an art, bro. Yeah, when you design that plate and you make that plate look all, make
yes,
it
sir. When you select seasonings, you know what I'm saying? And choose how I'm going to prepare this, like all of that's the thought process that go into art. You know
yeah,
what
yeah,
saying?
That's all art for sure.
Okay, so let's start with the rapping, with the music. You know, we got a studio right there. I rap, you know what I'm saying? I'm not much of a producer, like, but I can, on pen, like my boy 8-Ball said, but A-Ball said, freestyle, not great, but if you give me a second, I can write some shit down.
That yeah.
Gold record, you know what I'm saying? And so that's me. I'm nice with the pen and pad.
Okay,
you know what I'm saying?
I feel that way.
So talk about the rap you do. Is it H-Town kind of sounding?
Yeah.
Is it, because you're younger. I'm 44. You're 28, 29.
Yeah, 28, right? Yeah.
And so yeah, we got a whole decade plus in between us. You
yeah.
know what I'm saying? And so matter of fact, before we wrap up, man, I'm gonna put something on and see how I take you, man. Just see how I take you.
See where the beat takes.
Yeah, yeah.
That's really where I am as an artist, like as far as rap, you know, like or just music in general, like wherever that beat takes me, okay. I'm gonna be right there. You know what I'm saying? Like, you know, like Michael Jackson, I'm gonna be right there. Hey, but you know,
how long you been like making music?
I would say about like 5 years, maybe okay. more. I think when was Hurricane Harvey? That wasn't no 5 years ago. That was like I was doing that. So just
that probably was. That was pre-COVID.
A year, or two before Harvey, I was doing music. And okay. I did my first show in Houston at Super Happy Funland. Some little
Super Happy
Funland. Yes, it's some little like hipster spot, you know. But my boys put me on and we performed there. That was my first performance in Houston.
Okay.
I also performed in Boston one time with my homies, Free Bread Group. Shout out them.
Free Bread Group. Shout out to y'all. Bean Town. Y'all see this, man.
Post shout out to comments. The Bean. Shout out to everybody in the 02119 and all that, you know. But is that the right zip code?
Man, I went out to
that's the right zip code. Shout out Roxbury, you know.
That's what's up. That's
but
what's
up. Yeah, so the music.
Did y'all have you released anything?
I have music on SoundCloud. I had a song on Apple Music with my boy Desmond Reed. Shout out Des. And also with the Free Bread Group, I've had music on Apple Music. I think Spotify maybe.
Yeah, most likely. If y'all went through
SoundCloud, SoundCloud for sure. You can find me on SoundCloud, Ty Jones.
Ty Jones, I was just about to ask. And what's the songs that you think is on the streaming platforms?
What's the songs?
You know, I'm gonna go listen to it.
Songs, what's the name of that song? What's the name of that song?
Is it under Ty Jones?
It's under Papa D.
Papa D.
Papa D.
Who is Papa D?
That's my boy Dez. Dez. I've been thinking about this life. He got the hook, and I come in. Girl, I need you next to me when I come home from the streets. Sometimes wonder who loved me, but no emotions from a king. Girl, I throw it all away. It's no question, it's no doubt. I'm the man up in the drought, but when you gone, I feel wet out. Storms and rain, I feel the pain. Lord knows that I need your love. Rub your feet up in the tub. Girl, you know you got a thug. It ain't nothing to a G. Baby, you can call on me. Girl, I'll be there in a jiffy. You ain't gotta wait on me. No, no.
Hey man,
say Ty Jones in the building. I'm definitely gonna put on something now.
That was a
put on something right now. So shout out to Papa D.
Shout out Papa D.
You know what I'm saying? Shout out to Papa D, man. And y'all go search Papa D. Man, I want to say the name of the song, but I don't know it. You know?
Yeah, I don't know the name of the song. What's the name of the song, man?
I want to go find it. I'll find it later. I'm gonna post it in the comments, man. That's what's up. That's what's up, man. And Mo City Podcast, man. I'm Chuck. That's Ty Jones.
Yeah.
Y'all know what it is, man. Chris Tyler.
Shout out God, buddy, man.
I'm talking about I'm gonna say Hustler. because similar to me, boy, do everything.
About man.
Family man,
all
boy,
purpose.
Take photos, boy, shooting videos. So we're gonna get some work in on that. Here, artists, we got a nice vocal range. You know what I'm saying? Which I just experienced.
Yeah, it was a stop, man. It wasn't.
Yeah,
yeah.
But you know, I can tell.
Yeah.
And so we didn't have people in here being like, oh.
Yeah.
And so no, that's what's up, bro. So let's stay on the music for a minute. Who in the deck right now? Who you listening to?
Man. On the way over here, I said I was listening to the Zero for sure. I'm listening to the Zero damn near all the time. You know, I listen to Rose all the time.
It's cracking, fam.
Vandross, you know what I'm saying? Just the Crack album, the
Pressure.
Everything. Man, Crack album, my favorite album.
You know what I'm saying? Crack, that's your favorite?
That's my favorite whole album, I think.
Man, bro, I'm born and raised in Mo City.
Yeah.
So understand, like, I was one of them niggas who, when I was at the Ridge, Ro was there.
Oh, for real?
Yeah.
Damn.
You know what I'm saying? When I was at, but it was only for like a semester, maybe.
Mm.
I ain't see that nigga no more. But like, but yeah, like grew up on that nigga. I'm talking about just 25 albums in, 30 albums in. Like,
nah,
I
for sure.
Got all of them at a certain point. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, my brother put me on Zero.
At a certain point, had all of them in, man. No Love Boulevard is probably one of my top four row albums. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Followed by Crack.
For sure.
Look at What You Did to Me,
man.
And King of the Ghetto. So King, it's a toss up between King of the Ghetto and Zero versus the World.
Yeah, Zero versus the World. I love
it's, man, because both of them. Yeah, I was at an age where we was out there that was the music we was trapping to. King of the Ghetto, like we was listening to that.
When I was in school, it was all the drug albums. It was all the heroin, the crack, the meth. You know, it was all that. That's gotcha. Me and my brother. We was sitting in his Jetta. We was sitting there jamming that. You know, yeah, on the way to school.
Out to MoCity Don, man. King of the Ghetto.
I like Ro. I like Rod Wave.
Yeah,
Rod Wave, the truth.
Rod Wave a vibe, bro. Like he got great ride music.
Yeah.
Like, you can just flip. You know what I'm saying? You miss your exit jamming Rod and just because you just kind of, you know what I'm saying?
Rod Wave, man. He be singing them.
Yeah, you kind of almost, sorry, I ain't going to say sounded like him, but the melody and the kind of singing, rap singing was similar that you just did on that song right
there. Yeah, I like him. I rock with No Cap right now.
Okay.
No Cap from Alabama.
Mm-hmm. Somebody else was who was talking about No Cap, bro? I don't know where I was at, but I heard somebody else mentioning his name.
Yeah, I like No Cap, man. He go crazy. He be singing and he got a lot of bars, man. Like if you don't pay attention, them bars gonna go way over your head. And like I listened to a song by him like at least 100 times, bro. Some of the songs still went over my head. Some of the bars really went over my head. Like I was like, man. It's almost like when you listen to Wayne, when you finally get it, you know, that bar that you finally get.
It's a few of them, you know what I'm saying? That you listen to it 30 times and it's like, oh shit.
Yeah.
Meant that, you know what I'm saying? That's what's up. All right, No Cap, Range, salute to you. You like this, this is probably the second person that I brought your name up to me.
Yeah, shout out.
In the last 2 weeks, fam. And so I'm gonna check you out, you know what I'm saying? So expect a couple streams from me.
Yeah, he got some vibes, man. You gonna like it. Who else I be jamming? I like old music, I like new music. I listen to a lot of music, man. I was recently whooping somebody's ass on Madden to that Tina Turner, rest in peace.
R.I.P.
I was jamming all her music to that Tina Turner, man. R.I.P. I listened to all that, but
to the legend.
I got a lot of artists I listen to. I listen to myself, of course.
So let's talk about you. You working on new music?
At the moment, no. I was mad at myself the other day because I had the start of a song. I have like constant music playing in my head, and I had these lyrics come to my mind.
Or do you like just kind of express yourself? Like, I ain't gonna say freestyle because like my bro JT, he don't write, but he write in his head. Like,
yeah.
He sit there and kind of put it together and then
he punching in.
Sometimes.
Yeah.
Sometimes he'll get through a whole thing. Sometimes he'll punch in. It just depend on what we working on, how many people on the song, how much time we got, kind of deal. But how long we been working on the song, right? Mm-hmm. If we been had the beat, then he'll come in ready because he been had a long time to marinate on it.
Yeah, like I
need 90 minutes.
Oh, you can get it out like that.
Sometimes, if I really like the song,
yeah,
and it's a vibe, like somebody I got a real relationship with. Yeah, 90 minutes, dog. Let me get some Gary Payton in the hemp rap.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying.
And
let the beat play, bro, and give me about an hour and a half. And
some people really be on it, like they don't need. They just be going, like, man, I need to take a little bit more time. This is a craft, you know what I'm saying? I don't just be hopping in there and just spewing out bullshit. You know, I gotta have quality.
Is that, and then what I try to tell people as well is that, like, it's certain people who do it for a living.
Yeah.
Right.
It's therapeutic too.
Is it like for example, me, I make music and we got a bunch of music streaming everywhere, but I don't really eat off of it. You know what I'm saying? We eat off of the marketing.
Mm-hmm.
We eat off of the graphics and the websites and the media production and all of that. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, which is why I'm running to play with the MoCity Movie soundtrack. So we can all try to increase revenue on the music side. You know what I'm saying? And so, but with that being said, I tell people in reference to what you're saying, it's people who rap all the time. It's people who that's all they do is rap. Mm-hmm. And so if I was committed like that, but like I was back when I was probably 24, 25, 26. We was going hard back then. It wasn't no streaming, though. We was pressing up CDs, you know what I'm saying? And doing all of that. And so, at that time, I was sharp enough to go in there and just, what we talking about?
Yeah. Then, give me a topic.
To give you 16, 20, 30, you know what I'm saying? And run it like with no problems, full of bars that's just up here.
Yeah.
But now, I just need a moment. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, sometimes I like to write, you know, with some songs I've done, I was writing, like, let me just write this and I'm going to come back to you. And it would be hot, you know, or sometimes straight freestyle. I'm talking about no punching in, just straight going.
And so
it'd be like that.
And that comes, especially if you do it all the time. You know what I'm saying?
It's the vibe. I mean, I guess it's the vibe or the beat, wherever it takes.
It's all of that. It's the vibe. It's the beat. It's the practice. It's the rehearsal. It's the breathing. It's the repetition. It's all of that. You know what I'm saying? It's the life experiences, especially when you're talking about freestyling.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? If you ain't been through nothing, you ain't seen nothing, then ain't really nothing gonna come out.
Yeah, I grew up, you know, freestyling and making beats on the table and all that, you know, like talk about freestyling, and, you know, like I used to watch videos on Kiki and Flip, you know, them boys, you can really tell that those guys, you know, really practiced it.
Men's Fragrance, your home for 100% authentic men's cologne. We carry high-end fragrances like Creed, YSL, Gucci, Polo, and more with below retail prices. All orders come with free shipping. Order online at mens-fragrance.net. Men's Fragrance, smell good for less.
Really practice that all the time.
Man, this is what they do. You see at the top of my wall up there. Like DJ Screw.
Yeah. Right. RP Screw.
Man, and so, bro.
I got a song called Moyo right now.
RP to Moyo, man.
I got a song called Moyo with my boy J-Bird, Jordan B. It's on SoundCloud.
Was a cool ass nigga, bro.
Yeah. Oh, hard. That's my song right now. People fuck with that song. You gotta look that one up too.
RP to DJ Screw.
But yeah, I
Fat Pet.
I write, you know, freestyle. It's whatever comes to me. You know, I'm gonna sit there. I'm gonna visualize the song.
Yeah, of course.
And I'm gonna see where it needs to go. You know,
so you interested in working on another project? You got some like producers you like to work with, or
I have a friend that I work with. Shout out Melrose.
Melrose.
Shout out my boy. He official, man. He good, man.
He producer. Like,
he is engineer. I guess, you know, producer, engineer.
I mean, he make beats. Which a producer and a beat maker, they different, but they kind of people group them together.
Yeah.
But like, is he punching keys and creating sounds, or is he just like engineering and, you know, making it sound good?
He makes it sound good. Okay. And but you know, he can make his own, he makes his own beats too. Though.
Okay, yeah. I mean, which is a bunch of people who do both. Yeah. Like matter of fact, most producers do both. You know what I'm saying? Because they know how they want the end product to sound, you know what I'm saying? So they engineer as well.
But him, he's just a lot like me because he's an engineer, but he's also an artist. He also shoots videos. He's the whole thing, you know, like, and then the editing too. So it's shout out him. But yeah, I go to him to, you know, that's who I really record with.
Okay.
My boy.
Shout out to you, Mel Rose. That's what's up, bro. Post a comment. Leave some information when you see this, man. I'll link up with you.
Yeah, for sure. Tap in, Mel Rose.
Tap in.
And Diz, Berg, everybody tap in. Text tap in.
For sure, man. It's Ty Jones right there, bro. Y'all know who I am. MoCity Podcast, man. We in here just politicking for a minute. So I pride myself on being nice in the kitchen too, fam.
All right.
I'm nice in the kitchen too. Like in my household, I cook. Mm-hmm. I cook, my wife clean. That's how that go. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? And she fine with that, and I'm fine with it. You know what I'm saying?
I do it all.
Well, you just stay at home dad.
I do it all.
Good, you know what I'm saying? Like, but with that being said, my go-to, I'm nice with the Tex-Mex. I'm great on the brunch items and breakfast food.
You know
what I'm saying? I'm good with select soul food items. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, breakfast is really my thing, though. Like, okay. I think breakfast is
also my one favorite. Of the I ain't gonna say easier because I done seen people like just
mess up eggs
or mess up pancakes.
Pancakes,
you know what I'm saying?
I don't know how you do that.
Like, man, so I can tell you how. Shout out to my bro Soldier, man. This was some years ago. We was probably 25, 24 years old, how we was. Anyway. He called me over. He was like, Chuck, bro, I need you to show me how to do these pancakes. I keep burning them.
Oh, man.
We living in these apartments. And so I leave my apartment. I go to that new apartment, bro. He got the stove on.
That's why. No butter down. No oil. We know why.
I walk in. I see it's an electric stove. I see the red. I see the stove on. I'm like, bro, nigga.
That's why.
Turned that mud down to medium. Whipped up another batch. And then when I got ready to pour it in, he was finna turn the stove back up. I'm like, wait, fam, that's your problem. Leave it on medium. That stove probably still too hot.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying? And probably. Then they came out good and nice, and he was like, he had an eye opener. So it's people who don't know how to make eggs and don't know how to make pancakes.
Yeah.
And it's right. So you in the breakfast. Shout out to you, Soldier. Love you.
I'm in the breakfast. I'm into dinner. You know, I really like preparing a plate. And making it look nice, like, you know.
Okay.
And I like learning new things, you know. Like, sometimes I might go on TikTok and watch a little video or something, or, you know, go on YouTube and find something I like, you know, and just go home and make it. Go grab the ingredients.
I follow him on the gram, though. Shout out to, H-Town Chef, who coming to mind right now. I follow a bunch of them, though, who post just different recipes and different this and that and different techniques and different ideas.
Yeah.
Be like, okay, that was dope, man. I'll probably do it this way. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. I made some French toast, peanut butter, and jellies one time.
French toast, peanut butter, and jellies.
Yeah, them things was... So French toast, peanut butter, and jelly. If you don't know
like
how...
Like a peanut butter and jelly sandwich and then done French toast style? Like dipped and then pan fried?
Yes, exactly. Yeah. So you just...
I got it. I can see it.
You could even do it with just jelly. You know, take you a piece of bread. I cut mine in half, and I just roll it up, and I put it, and I dip it in the egg, and I put egg, cinnamon, and vanilla.
Vanilla extract.
Yeah.
Drop.
So, and then put that in there, and just dip it in there, and put it on the grill, put it on the stove, let that thing cook, and it's good, man. It's a good, nice little, you know, breakfast little...
All right, so...
Get you on the go.
I'm going to put you on game. Put you on game.
But I just did that. It was my first time doing that recently. Like, it's okay. It's good. Mm-hmm. It's good. I like it. My kids like it.
After you roll it, air fry it.
Yeah, I don't got an air fryer, though.
You tell me what you told.
I mean, I've used the air fryer before, and it was good. I don't know. Sometimes, I guess it depends on what product you use or which...
What you're making. Everything ain't good in it.
Because
I've learned to just been using it in different kind of ways. That's like, oh snap, this bring a whole different texture to it.
Yeah, but like some of those machines, like when you use them, they have like a factory smell or taste to them, like once you cook with it. Mm-hmm. So I don't know if it's having to do with cleaning or whatever you got to do to it, but that's...
Oh, well, probably just run it first.
Yeah.
They probably just run it first, you know what I'm saying? And then I use the, we've ordered... They look like coffee filters. They air fryer filters.
Oh, yeah. Just
like, and we use those, so that way it's easy to dispose of. But yeah, get your air fryer.
Yeah, it'll save me some time.
It's gonna save you a bunch of time.
I ain't gonna be smelling like grease all the time.
And then it's gonna change the game on other stuff. Like, I just found out, I'm gonna tell you, that's a game changer. If you like biscuits.
Yeah.
Air fryer biscuits.
Oh, wow. But bro, you need a big air fryer, like.
Well, yeah, because you got little kids. I've been there. And when mine was little. So I got three. My wife got two. And so together we had five when they was young. You know what I'm saying? So it was, well, not young, but mine was. Anyway, I used to cook meals for eight or seven. You know what I'm saying? At once. And so I know what you mean by having
I need a big air fryer. I cook a lot, man. I don't just cook for one setting. I never cook for one setting.
Because you got little ones and they eat so randomly. Like and
even before I had
take
kids.
Food to go to work, probably like,
So even before I had kids, though, I get it from my dad, though, because I used to watch my dad cook all the time, and my dad would be like, just having pots and big, huge pots full of food, and I'm like, man, who you cooking for, man? Because it's only me and mama up in here, and you just cooking all this food,
and it all get eaten.
It all get eaten because I was up in there, I was eating it all.
Bro, shout out to we need to cook more. I've been trying to eat out less and cook more. You know what I'm saying? My challenge be just to work the grind.
It's nice to go out to eat, you know, have somebody cook for you, especially if you're the main cooker in the house. But you know, save some money and cook at home. Enjoy yourself, watch a movie with your spouse.
Not just that, it's usually healthier, much healthier.
It's healthy.
You definitely gotta you know what's in it.
Yeah, you know what's in your ingredients.
You know, that this, you know, I was having this debate. And who was we eating with? Fried Catfish came up. And I was like, how can you prove that that's not swai? Right? So I don't really like the swai. It looked like catfish, but it is not. You know what I'm saying? And so my bro was like, bro, this catfish. I was like, it is. I believe you. But because I believe you because they told us it was. It kind of tastes like it. You know what I'm saying? And that's what it's on the menu. But how do you know?
How can you prove it?
How can you prove it, bro? You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, unless and you caught it yourself.
And so that kind of stuff is not a concern when you're preparing your own meals.
Yeah.
Straight up, man. So that's what's up, man. So you cooking, man, you making music. So I definitely want to help you out with some music. You know what I'm saying? See, we got a studio here. I know you ain't necessarily in the mode like that, but when you're out here,
yeah,
you know what I'm saying? Pull up.
I'm
usually in the building, you know what I'm saying? And we'll get JT here. We'll put on something. Matter of fact, let me do that right by now. See what I got over here. I should have.
Oh, look,
I got here late today. I ain't even get a chance to test, so hopefully this play.
I'm gonna go, man.
See what this is, bro.
They want to play a beat.
Yeah, just want to play a beat, man. I should have had some. That's what I need to do. All producers who may be looking at this here, I want y'all to start sending me original beats, and I'm just going to keep them in the library. I ain't going to share them or nothing like that, but I'm just going to randomly play them when I got an artist next
to me. Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? And then that way you'll get somebody you probably ain't never heard of rapping on a beat, and he'll be rapping on a beat from somebody he probably ain't never heard of.
Right.
And I've been in position to make a new connection. You know what I'm saying? And so if you're a producer out here, you're a beat maker, man. Post your links in the comments, bro. Let's tap in. Let's see here. Let me come over here. Let me open.
Don't nobody say nothing. I got an Android phone in my hand. It ain't mine.
I'm Team Android. What you talking about?
I got an Android phone in my hand. It ain't mine.
Oh, can you hear that?
Oh, yeah, I hear it.
Hey, y'all hear that? Y'all know what it is, man. Mm. It's Chip right now. I got Todd Jones in the building. MoCity Podcast.
We
got politics. You know what I'm saying? He said he an artist, man. He said people put beats on, I just see where it takes me.
Yeah.
Yo.
I got a big booty freak, and she's straight out of Texas. All my niggas, they real, and my niggas, they reckless. And you play with the gang, and we gonna pull up. And I...
Yeah, took at the table.
Yeah,
been watching the cable.
Yeah,
styling for a while. More serious than Rabel.
Yeah,
all the E into the T. Enterprise of entertainment. But one thing for sure, man, that ain't to be played with.
Ain't to be played with. Ain't to be fucked with. In the Motown, nigga, we gonna get buck quick. We gonna get real. It's gonna get street. Nigga try to play pack with that heat.
Pack with the heat, cause I got it next to my pocket. If you try to stop it, then I blast off like a rocket. Shout out to Dream Elijah One, 94 and 95. Those were the years that we got it done.
Man, hold up.
Y'all know what it is.
And she straight out of Texas. All my niggas, they real. And they straight out of Texas. Hey.
Man, y'all know what it is, man. MoCity Podcast, bro. I'm in here with Todd Jones. We in here just politicking.
Send
some bars. You want to hear one more?
Okay.
I'll give you one more, bro.
Switch the beat. Surprise me.
Surprise you. I only got two of them on here right now.
It's all good. It's all good.
This will be the other.
Shout out to everybody listening, man. Shout out MoCity. Shout out everybody in MoCity, man. It's going down, man.
Let's see here. See what this will take you, man.
MoCity the movie coming soon, man.
July 9th. MoCity the movie. You know what I'm saying? Shout out to everybody who played a part in that thing. Trill Spill.
Hey! Got it.
Yeah. RIP
Takeoff, man.
Yeah. Hey. Todd Jones, MoCity Podcast.
I pop a break just to feel it.
In the killing.
Yeah. Hold on, man.
She'll spill it.
These beats, man.
Running up like them Legos, I feel it.
Yeah.
Sitting the invoice, I'm trying to get this cash.
Cash.
It's running up on me now, niggas blast. Then you pass. I try to keep it righteous, but they run up on me. But I got the Nikes.
Nikes.
I ain't run up, no. Try to keep some J's.
J's.
In here with the Todd Jones, man, we creating plays.
Plays.
Sitting to put it together. in the middle of the room.
Hey, hold on.
MoCity The Movie, you know it's coming soon.
Hey, hey, you know it's coming soon. You know that Ty John V with that Legion of Doom. Hey, hit your front door, nigga, knock not one, not one time. That nigga say he gonna knock not one time. Hey,
knock not one time. Donut,
open that door. Cause you know that Ty Jones ain't no hoe. Cause you know that Ty Jones is a pro. I'm rolling with the gang and we on it. I'm a nose. Yeah. Parlay. What's the parlay? I'm in the hood all day. Yeah. What's the deal? What's the move? Hey, you try to play you on the news. God body fam. I'ma do it for my fucking fam.
Hey man.
This is play, man. Play freestyle.
Y'all know what it is. We ain't even had the point, man.
I could have sang anything. Let me see if I can sing on this. Nah,
hey, man. Look, we go. That was enough fun, bro. That was enough fun. I appreciate you. Appreciate you doing that, yeah, man. Look, that. I ain't even freestyled in a minute, bro.
It's been a long time since I freestyled, man. If you want to look up my song, any type of music, go to Ty Jones. On SoundCloud, probably YouTube, maybe. Yeah.
So we're going to work on that. We're
working on that right now.
Boys definitely got talent, man. And so
but the movie coming soon.
We're going to put something together, man. And then I'm going to make sure that y'all can go find it streaming everywhere. You know what I'm saying? That's the play we'll put together.
Put it everywhere.
You start writing.
I'm going to start writing.
Yeah, you start writing, fam.
Find me a beat that I really, really like.
Just start writing. Crazy. Start getting off your emotions. Start kind of inventorying the stuff you go through in life. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
start
I can show you some shit where I'm really going.
Because you got a lot. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. You got a lot. You're a family man. You're raising kids. You're a stay-at-home dad. That's rare for us.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? It's rare for us.
And some people look down on that, but you know what?
No, bro, I've been there.
Man. Fuck you.
And the reality is that time with them kids is priceless.
Nah, it's
bro.
Precious.
Who better to pour into them at that developmental stage in their life than their father?
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
I'm happy I'm able to.
Yeah, so bro, please don't feel bad about that. And to the haters,
I'm
bro,
not listening to nobody, okay, man.
Thank you, dog.
I'm not listening to nobody, man, because they just talking, man. They don't know the situation or nothing that's going on. So
yeah, and so I'm a believer, bro. And so I pray for healing. You know what I'm saying? I know you're dealing with an injury.
Yeah,
and so so I pray for healing, bro. And I pray for the unity of you and Ms. Wendy and y'all family, bro. So,
yeah, thank you.
So I met the children, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, you met the kids.
So they're beautiful kids.
Bro. Thank you.
And so man, y'all, this is MoCity Podcast. I'm here politicking with Ty Jones, bro.
Get it, man.
Hit him up, bro. Y'all see the IG handle right there, bro. Shoot videos, boy. Do photography. He an artist. You want to feature? He available, bro. He's actor. You know what I'm saying? Oh, so that's what I was gonna ask you. You said you and Andrea was working on a new project.
Yeah.
So I know that's. Can you talk about that?
I can talk about it. Okay. Yeah.
So what y'all cooking up? What's she cooking up?
I don't have the title. I can't give the title of the movie out because it's not a title yet. Mm-hmm. It had a title, but it changed. So that's because the title that we had was already a name of another movie. Gotcha. So we had to, come together and
make some adjustments.
Else. Yeah, but the movie's already done. We just doing the credits right now, I believe.
Okay.
But yeah, it's got Andrea. She's actually acting in the movie. Samaki Lee is in the movie. Tamara Samaki, Carson's in the movie.
Hit me up, Samaki. I'm waiting on you.
Yeah, Tamara Carson's in the movie. My boy, Mike. He shot the movie.
Okay.
And Andrea was also directing the movie too. But that movie's coming out this summer as well.
So shout to you, Andrea. That's a big move. You about to see two releases this summer.
Two releases, and this is my first two projects that I've ever been a part of. You know, so you know, I ain't gonna lie. I was sitting on the toilet, man. I was like, man, I'm just thanking God because you know this is something like people really dream of. You know, like you know, we gonna have a premiere on a big screen.
Yeah, so
you know, at a theater. You know, so.
And that's what I was telling somebody else because somebody was asking me, but man, Chuck, y'all had all them challenges with the movie and da-da-da-da, bro. Like, have you seen it, man? Is it a good movie, da-da-da-da? Yeah. I was like, bro, I saw the rough cut and I helped with the edit. So,
yeah.
And we did have a bunch of challenges.
And so I'm thankful that I was even had the opportunity. You know what I'm saying? I'm thankful that it's finna be on the big screen. Right. And it's a ratchet comedy, bro. It's funny. It everybody donated their time and effort, and we had fun doing it.
Yeah.
And so, like, I don't really care what y'all think. You know what I'm saying? If you like it, great. Support it. Share it. If you don't like it, hopefully you paid to see it. You know what I'm saying? And so, and that's where I'm at with it. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And so, this MoCity The Movie, that'll come in soon, July 9th, this summer, 2023. Look, go to Eventbrite. Search up MoCity The Movie. Tickets available right now. They got regular tickets. We got VIP tickets where you can take a picture with us and the cast.
Donations.
And the directors. Yeah, we got, we looking, I think they look for sponsors and vendors if you want to be a part of that.
Right.
Reach out to GoDJC Money, man. Reach out to Mo McCoy. Make that happen. Or y'all can go to moserious.com/mo-city-movie. And Eventbrite button right there. The trailer right there. You can watch that. And yeah, that's what it is, bro. So I usually wrap up with this part. I call it words and thoughts, right? Mm-hmm. So I'm gonna give you one word. You tell me what that made you, that word made you, what thought it brought to your mind.
For sure.
And with you being a stay-at-home dad, my first word is family.
Family. I got like this thing on my wall in my right by my kitchen that says family is everything.
Mm-hmm.
And so
FOE.
And then I it brings this movie to my mind that you know, The Godfather. He said a man cannot be a man unless he spent time with his family.
Mm.
You know, so like I take family to heart, man.
A man unless he spent time with his family.
Exactly. You know.
Godfather.
And you know, spending time with my family is just—it's everything, man. I'm the one in my family that, you know, I reach out to other siblings. You know, they be, God nowhere, and I'm like, you know, what's up, man? What's going on? I'm your cousin. I'm your uncle, man. What's up? Tap in. Let's do something.
Let's do this. Let's just connect.
Yeah, I want family around, because when I was younger, my dad used to have family members come over, and that was the happiest I seen him.
Mm-hmm.
You know, he would be the happiest.
When the family came over.
So, you know, he was laughing and joking and everything.
And
you know,
when they weren't there,
he was just, you know, stiff, stern, you know, don't do that. You know, just, that was my dad. But, and I love my dad, you know, but, you know.
Man, that's what they, family do.
Yeah,
that's
they showed me that, you know, being around your family is really, it's really where it's at, you know, being happy and enjoying quality time with people you love.
Mm-hmm.
And that's what I take a lot of pride in, you know, just communicate, you know, cause I got family members and I ain't gonna talk bad about them, but you know, they don't reach out. You know, we live in the same city.
Mm-hmm.
Ain't no reason that we shouldn't be communicating or meeting up, going to have dinner or something like that. You know,
big old facts.
Yeah,
that's why, I got cousins, right? I got family and cousins, and I'm a slug y'all. I got cousins who ain't been to my spot yet. You know what I'm saying? And I done asked.
Pull up, man. It's going down over here. It's nice.
I got a cousin who make beats, bro. And I got a studio right on the other side of the wall, but they ain't pulled up yet.
Mm.
And so, yeah, you know who you is, fam. And I love you. And I can't wait to see you and have a drink with you. But I would love to work with you.
Yeah.
Straight up. And so, so that was family. That was family. Next word for you is support.
Support. You need a great support system to be successful at anything, really. Nobody in this world does anything alone. And you always need your team to be right there with you. Even when you raising kids, we talk about raising kids, you gotta have that support system. It takes a village to raise a family. So, support, man. I've got nothing but support, you know, since I started making this movie, MoCity. I got nothing but support, you know, like friends and you know, family, nothing but support. Even people that I haven't talked to in years.
Like, just glad to see you doing
something. Yeah, just glad to see I'm, you know, on the right path, you know, not in trouble or nothing like that, you know, just, you know, and I'm thankful myself, man. So,
that's what's up.
Yeah. You need that support, man.
And I'm a believer, you know what I'm saying? I believe in Jesus.
Right.
How do you feel about religion? That's the next word.
Okay. I believe in Jesus as well. I believe in God, you know. religion, a lot of people, they don't like that word. You know, they think that...
Yeah, I'm not a fan of it either.
Yeah, yeah.
I'm more relationship over religion.
Because it is a relationship. You know, anytime you become a Christian or I guess any type of religion or belief, yeah. It's a relationship. You know, it's because you have to form that bond with God. You mm-hmm. know, it's a you thing. It ain't everybody else, it's you. And I haven't been to church in a while. And I feel bad about that, but I grew up in church, and so I know a lot about the word. I've been on missionary trips. Okay. I've been out the country before, you know, trying to tell people about God. I went to Budapest, Hungary, and
life-changing experience, probably.
Definitely a life-changing experience, seeing God firsthand, really, because I was going through something. We were in a group. It was like 3-4 guys and 2-3 girls, and the guys surrounded
3-4 guys. Okay, so about 7-8 of y'all.
Yeah. So we surround the girls. The guys surround the girls, and we move up this escalator.
Okay.
And me, I was in high school, and young and dumb. You know, I had this big old cowboy wallet. I'm talking about cowboy with this big, sticking out my back pocket. And we over here taking pictures and stuff, man. And he like, we look at the picture that we took, and I was like, who's that guy in the background? Some weird dude. You know, he was just like there, just like his head was popping out.
Mm-hmm.
And I was like, who the hell is that? And then, like, I'm reaching, like, we get down the escalator, I'm reaching around for my wallet. I don't know where it's at.
Mm.
So I'm losing it, bro. Like, I'm so heated, I'm so mad. Because these people saw him, like, that I was with.
Yeah.
They, like, saw him, like, trying to do something, like, behind me.
Yeah, he's in the picture.
Yeah, he's in the picture. And they kind of saw him. And I was mad at them. You know, and I'm sorry, I was mad at y'all. But I was mad at them.
Yeah.
And that dude, if I would have found him, I would have killed him. I would have killed him or done something bad. Like, we were in another country, and you know,
yeah.
You can't get caught up nothing like that in another country.
You're not coming back to the
States. You're not coming back. So, man, I was so heartbroken, man. I had American money, I had foreign money, my ID was in there, everything, and
passport, all that kind of stuff. Because
I still had my passport.
Okay.
But just everything that had anything with my ID on it, it was there, and it was gone, and that shit crushed me, man. And later on that night, we were sitting there, they were sitting there having pizza at this little pizza spot.
Mm-hmm.
And I just wasn't feeling it, man. I was outside still mad. Cool. And my mentor that was out there with me, his name's Kirk, he just came to me. He was like, he's like Chris.
Missionary group.
Yeah, yeah. He was like, Chris, man, I know you mad right now, but I gotta tell you something. He was like, before we left out of here, before we left to even come to Budapest, there was a man that called my phone or called his phone. That was like, you know, I just want to make sure that you're fully funded. You got everything you need. And my guy Kirk was like, yeah, I'm good. I got everything I need. We're set to go. He was like, all right. But I want to give you this here. He gave him some money. He sent him some money. He's like, I just know that you're going to need this here.
Mm-hmm.
And I don't know what for, but you're going
to need it.
You're going to need it. And that's exactly what he told me. And he was like, I believe that God put it in his heart that he knew that this was going to happen. And he gave me that money, and it was double the money that I already had. And so, I mean, when he gave me that money, I broke down crying, man. Cause I was like, man, God, the devil was really trying to rob me, man. Like, and he did, he robbed me of my joy and literally of my money, you know? So,
that's his whole job, steal, kill, and destroy, yeah. You know what I'm saying? And so,
but you know, I was so thankful for that moment because it really, show me that, you know, that I am a person of God. Like God really has his hands over me because, you know, like certain things could go on in your life and God just be there to really comfort you. That's mm-hmm. what I needed in that moment was comforting. And I was immediately comforted. You know, like it's only a feeling that you get.
Yeah.
You know, and it's hard to describe, but
I can describe it for you. Watch this. It feel like
it's immediate
from mama.
Yeah, it's immediate. It's immediate.
When mama hug you, everything stopped for that moment.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
That's the thing about God, man.
Yeah, exactly, yeah. Bro. And so that's the closest thing.
Yeah.
And that's so far away from
so far,
it.
Yeah.
But that's the closest thing. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And so, man, yeah, no, God is real, bro. God is real, bro. And I'm one of the ones who when I release music, for example, I try to share that in our music. You know what I'm saying? I try to stand on that when I'm having conversations with people.
Yeah.
And, you know, and I've been that way, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And so
that was me for a long time, you know. I'm still very much a believer in God, you know. You know, my music may not line up with it, but you know,
yeah, and teach his own, you know what I'm saying? Like that's no judgment at all. That's just is what it is.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying? Like that is what it is. Your music is what that's how you express yourself. And that's fine.
And another thing, like I don't understand how like I've been to Colorado before. You know, I've been in the mountains. And when I went in the mountains, I was just really at awe of God's creation.
Mm-hmm.
Because you look at the mountains, you're like, damn.
Yeah. Like mountains are crazy. I haven't been to Colorado. I've been to Seattle, seen mountains there. Was just in Phoenix a couple weeks ago.
Oh yeah,
you know, drove through the mountains there.
Yeah.
So yeah, it's just like, man, just yeah.
It's when you get up there. I was doing hiking. I was hiking.
Oh, okay, so you got a chance to walk through them and really see it.
I was really seeing it. So I was like, man, just God, look at all this. Like, ain't no way, because there's in Colorado, there's a lot of atheist people there. That's why we went to Colorado. Number one. To go and minister to the non-believers. So that was definitely a challenge.
Yeah.
You know, but it's a lot of people out there, but
which is real missionary work.
Real missionary work.
Real missionary work,
yeah.
Right? There's one thing to kind of sit in the four walls, right? And talk to a group of people who already believe and they here for a different reason because they want inspiration. It's another thing to go talk to a whole group of people where they at. Who don't believe, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And so that's what the Colorado mission was on.
Yeah, I mean, initially it was as a camp at a YMCA, which is really big, and we would go out there and just have like a whole bunch of fellowship with people from around the world would come there. I'm not around the states.
Usually, because YMCA be regional.
Yeah. So they would come from there, but we weren't a part of no YMCA.
Oh, y'all would just
we just stayed there. So, you know, and they would have preachers and ministers come from everywhere to come and talk to us. But at the end of the day, like on a couple of last days while we were there, because we stayed there for like almost a week.
Okay.
And so the last towards the end of the trip, we would go and do missionary work.
Okay, go out here and network and talk to people.
Yeah, after we've learned so much, you know, we go out and it's time to put that to work.
Gotcha.
You know, so that's exactly what we was doing out there. And same for out of the country too as well. But you know, it's definitely a challenge being a believer, man, in this world where there's so much negativity and so many you could say false prophets or people that, you know, are claiming God but really wolves in sheep's clothing, you know. But
yeah,
that's a whole nother story.
It's that, and then you had the challenges with you know, the Bible we read says we are not of this world. You know what I'm saying?
Mm.
And so, but at the same time, right, we live in this world,
right?
And so, yeah, the struggle with self, right? Because you gotta defeat self. I kill self every day to be
got to.
You know what I'm saying?
It's an everyday challenge.
I gotta kill self first, and then after I kill self. Then I got to go deal with the world, you know what I'm saying? And the world be totally against most of the stuff I believe, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, and it'd be hard to open up to other people, but me, I don't really, you know.
No, it ain't hard, it's just.
I don't find it hard, but a lot of people do.
Well, so the world makes it not appropriate.
Really not appropriate.
In certain states, it's illegal, you know what I'm saying?
Really?
And so, yeah, certain places, yeah, we can't talk religion here, you know what I'm saying? We can't talk spirituality here. We're going to, like, schools.
Yeah, schools.
You know what I'm saying? I'll give you one example. Like, it's just certain, so the society, but we send our children there every day.
You're
raising them. You might be praying with them every morning and getting them right and doing this and there. So they're in the right mental space, and now they got to go to school. And they ain't going to have that environment. You know what I'm saying? And so it's like, it's those things. You know what I'm saying? And you can go on and on about stuff that's in the society that's contrary to what we believe. You know what I'm saying? But at the same time, you got to walk the line of standing on what you believe, controlling what how you move, and for me personally, staying out the way. You know what I'm saying?
Gotta stay out the way, man.
Staying out the way. And so I try to walk in right.
Put your head down. And
stay out the way, bro. That'd be my goal, you know what I'm saying? And then if people want to rock with me, hit me up, tap in, you know what I'm saying? And then we can work. I'm not out the way at that point, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
But other than that, I'm trying to stay out of the way. Man, so that's what's up. I had two more words. Loyalty.
Loyalty. Loyalty, loyalty, loyalty.
Straight up.
Loyalty is, what's life without loyalty? You know, what's a man without his best friend? You know, they say the most loyal person is a dog. But I love anybody who love me and anybody who's loyal to me. You know, I love y'all. So I know who's loyal to me. I know who's loyal to me and you know, I see you, and I'm loyal right back. I'm probably one of the most loyal people there.
And part of that's probably just due to, you said you're the youngest of how many?
Seven.
Yeah. And so when you got older siblings, and I don't even have older siblings. Like, I had a younger sister, you know what I'm saying? But the people I know who have older siblings, the younger ones tend to gravitate towards family, tend to be more loyal just because they usually had a bunch of hand-me-downs. They usually kind of go through
this
experience.
That was me.
You know what I'm saying? Of getting all these things. And so you be loyal to those above you. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, that was me.
And so that's what's up. That's what's up, bro. Man, so, Mo City Podcast, man, that's Ty Jones.
Mo City.
Y'all know what it is,
we
bro.
We in Mo City right now.
Right now. 2234 Wells Fargo building, man. Y'all know where I'm at. Bro, so let's go out on this note. I ain't going to say give me last words because we definitely got more work to do. We're going to talk again.
Mm.
But right now, while you got the attention of my audience, you know what I'm saying? Just leave us with something, bro, whatever on your heart, and then we out.
Through all things, keep God first, man. All things. And, before I even left the house on the way over here, I was like, man, God, please just let this be a good interview and let, everything flow right. You know, I even told God, like, if this acting thing is for me, I'm going to know. He's going to let me know, because it won't happen.
Exactly.
It'll fall. So, just keep God first, stay humble, and practice what you believe in. Practice what you preach. Everything.
for real.
Yeah.
That's what's
and
up,
come man. Come see the premiere July 9th.
July 9th.
We man. Want you to, I want to see you. I want to see my friends. My teachers, who else?
Yeah. So it's a come out, man. It's a dope movie. Without telling y'all too much, it's a story about a guy, a prominent man from Mo City. He got 8 sons. We playing a son. I'm playing the son. He playing one of the sons. That's why we brothers. We all got different mamas. You know what I'm saying? But we learning a lesson about the family.
Right.
And it's set in Mo City.
Through hardships.
Yeah. That's about what I can tell you. We learning a big lesson about the family and how our pops was moving. We all learned some lessons about each other that we ain't know. And shout out to Andrea. Shout out to the writers, man. Shout out to
Mo McCoy.
And Brenda came through on the
Brenda
second
Brown.
Half. And helped produce and direct.
Yeah, she was a big part of my photography part, you know, me taking pictures. She, when I came across some of the girls there, it was a little timid, I guess. I guess they weren't very comfortable with me at the time yet. So Brenda stepped in and she just had to, you know, let loose. Brenda stepped in and she was telling them what to do. I was like, okay, here we go.
I had to shout out to her.
Nah, it was good though. I like Brenda. I like everybody on the cast. Shout out everybody on the cast. And bro. I'm just excited, man. I'm ready. July 9th.
That's what that is, man. Y'all been tuned into the MoCity podcast, man. I'm Chuck. That's Ty Jones, man. Chris Tyler. And we out.
Let's get it, y'all.